While the world of automobiles is still embracing full cell battery technology to combat the scary consequences of climate change, something shinier has been discovered, by the way. The full cell battery technology is giving a ray of hope in the face of the climate crisis. But there is a need to accelerate mitigation actions. The era of combustion engines is sliding fast into the background, but something other than lithium batteries will fuel automobiles now. The sticky white hydrogen paste might just become the most important primary source of energy for automobiles. The invention has been catching the interest of car dealers around the world, and you just may be curious about it like them. Stick around the video to find out more about the power paste. Sustainable energy became a world sensation when Tesla owner Elon Musk started rolling out lithium-ion battery-powered vehicles. Ever since, other battery power options like sodium batteries, silicon batteries, zinc-ion batteries, solid-state, and dual-carbon battery options have been introduced into the market, and more car manufacturers are switching to the production of automobiles powered by batteries. This option, although better for the environment, is not cheaper and completely safe. This is why manufacturers are looking for a more viable and cheaper, eco-friendly option to lean toward. Hydrogen tech is a better option, but it comes with storage problems. Its volatility also makes it less of a better option because it can only be used by bigger vehicles in its current state. Hydrogen needs to be fitted in a high-pressure tank which cannot be stored in a car or smaller vehicle like a scooter. That's no longer a problem now that a powder paste has been introduced. The sticky substance is made of hydrogen, and it will now power small vehicles and motorcycles. The Fraunhofer Institute for Manufacturing and Advanced Materials, IFAM, and Dresden have preferred the new solution to the problem. The situation has been turned around now that they've created a way to store hydrogen in a paste. It is stored in its chemical form and will be easily transported. There are so many perks of the new hydrogen paste. First, the easy transportation, as mentioned before. The next is the absence of filling stations as we have now with the electric cars. The extensive network of filling stations that are expensive to set up will be a thing of the past. Vehicles that run on hydrogen paste will have reinforced fuel tanks that can hold 700 bar of pressure when filled. This tank supplies the fuel cell that uses hydrogen to produce energy. This in turn powers an electric motor, which moves the car forward. Magnesium hydride is used as the foundation of the power paste. This indicates that magnesium is the primary component of power paste. And in case you didn't know, magnesium is one of the elements with the greatest abundance on Earth and is a readily available raw material. Magnesium powder interacts with hydrogen in power paste at 350 degrees Celsius and 5 to 6 times atmospheric pressure to produce magnesium hydride. The power paste is then created using metal and salt ester. The magnesium hydride will make it possible to hold the hydrogen chemically at room temperature and atmospheric pressure. Then, whenever necessary, it will release. Power paste is taken out of a cartridge inside the vehicle using a plunger when it is being utilized. When water is injected into the succeeding reaction from an onboard tank, the amount of hydrogen gas produced is dynamically adjusted to the actual needs of the fuel cell. Actually, only half of the hydrogen is present in the power paste. The other half has been supplied by the water that has been added. It has an extremely high energy storage density as a result. It exceeds a high-pressure tank with a 700 bar gauge by a wide margin. Additionally, paste has a range that is on par with or even greater than that of gasoline thanks to its 10 times greater energy storage density than batteries. With a 700 bar pressure, it also provides a longer range than compressed hydrogen. Power paste will replace the cylindrical pressure tank in a fuel cell used by cars and buses, which is what makes it so inexpensively feasible and secure. IFAM contends that the method is ideal for hydrogen to be utilized in smaller vehicles because pressure tanks cannot be installed in them. Furthermore, it is an incredible technology that calls for tap water to be used to fill up half the tank. Just consider, if we use water to power our cars, what other options are there? There won't be any range concerns because a driver can easily get a range that is at least as long as that of a gasoline-powered automobile with power paste. At any time during a journey, a paste cartridge can be changed. For instance, at a gas station, one would only need to remove the cartridge and replace it with a full one to fill up a scooter. It may take on the form of a barbecue gas bottle. This makes using clean replacement energy in a variety of compatible products relatively simple. The researchers hypothesized that the paste might greatly extend the flight time of big drones, enabling them to fly for many hours as opposed to just 20 minutes. In a home setting, this would enable foresters, surveyors, or high-voltage electricians to utilize a drone to examine trees or electrical lines. In addition to a large operational range, campers may also use the fuel cell paste to power a toaster or coffee machine. It does not require costly infrastructure, unlike hydrogen gas. It is therefore ideal for locations lacking hydrogen stations. Power paste canisters or cartridges may be sold at conventional petrol stations. The researchers speculate that instead of only 20 minutes, the paste might significantly increase the flight time of large drones, allowing them to fly for many hours. Furthermore, H2 power paste is completely risk-free and easier to use than standard gaseous and liquid H2 power. Paste may be delivered in barrels or tankers without any difficulty or risk. IFAM intends to produce 4 tons of the energy goop per year at its first fully functioning power paste prototype facility, which is scheduled to debut in late 2022. The plant's location will be at the Fraunhofer Project Center for Energy Storage and Systems. Of course, there are still concerns and problems that need to be resolved, such as whether or not the magnesium in a used paste can now be recycled, how much water will be required for a specific quantity of energy, and how much would be required for refilling. The most crucial factor, of course, is how energy efficient the power paste will be. However, no technology on Earth is perfect, and for now, power paste is unquestionably seeming to be a promising answer for affordable, secure, and sustainable energy. The time has come to phase out combustion-powered automobiles. And by 2030 to 2050, most significant automakers aim to switch to electric vehicles. The next several years are expected to see a significant increase in the hydrogen industry. ZeroAvia, a company that is creating hydrogen-powered aircraft, has already received funding from Jeff Bezos and Bill Gates. In 2016, Germany spent 265 million euros in hydrogen vehicles. As more practical substitutes become available, other countries may follow. As long as it's produced using just pure energy, we can see implementing it at gas stations without too much difficulty. But in a world where access to clean energy is still limited, it could appear to be a waste of our solar and wind resources. On the other hand, it might completely change the landscape of sustainable energy. We'll just have to wait and see. Recent reports suggest that by 2025, BMW and Toyota's collaboration on a hydrogen fuel cell will be complete. BMW sales chief Peter Nota recently stated that the two behemoth manufacturers will begin co-producing and selling hydrogen fuel cell-powered vehicles as early as mid-decade. To learn more about that and how hydrogen cell-fueled vehicles work, take a look at this video.